Hello dear student, good morning. In the previous part of the chapter we have discussed about a lady Joan of Arc. Actually she is the pride of France, heroine of the France, national symbol of pride and full of patriotism and willpower to do something for the nation. The situation was that most of the area of France, near about 70 to 80% area of the France, was captured, covered by English soldiers. Here, all the French army, their soldiers, their countrymen, and the king or the prince were too much afraid of English army, and they were in the mindset of in the confusion state that what should they do to free the French, to free the France, French part from English army. Here the situation was going on, the very serious situation was there. They didn't have any option to see, they didn't have any hope to escape from that situation. Somehow this was the background of that play and how the play starts. Now we are moving toward the start. Before moving to start the play, we must familiar with the character in the play. The characters are Robert, it is the captain of French army. Stewart is a soldier, it is assistant of to Robert. Joan is the main lead, main role or main character in the play. Joan, heroine, we can say that heroine of the play, and accordingly the assistant to Joan. Some other minor characters are there, but these are the major characters in the play. And the most important character in the play is that Joan. Dear student, if you watch the movie Bahubali, and that Bahubali there was a scene that where the Bahubali's army and Bhallal Dev's army was defeated by that Kalkev. And all the soldiers were just ready to run away from the battlefield. At that time, there was a dialogue which put the fire and charged the emotions and patriotism, and which put the confidence, which boost the confidence in the soldier. That dialogue was told by Bahubali. क्या है मृत्यु, मैं वो मृत्यु को मारने जा रहा हूँ, डर से भय से भाग जाना, मातृभूमि से भाग जाना, यह है मृत्यु. Somehow that character was similar with Joan. Joan was the girl which was very much intensified and very much which had a very very strong will to defeat to the opponent. That somehow character we can imagine in this play, that Bahubali told the soldiers, kya hai mrityu, main us mrityu ko maarne ja raha hu, main wo agar matrubhumi se aap bhagte ho to wo hai mrityu, dar ke mar jana, yeh hai mrityu. And the soldiers charged their emotions and they stood again in the battlefield, and Bahubali directly ran his horse towards Kalki, and ultimately the Kalki was killed by Bahubali and Bhallal Deva in that Bahubali movie. Same character was there. When the soldier lost the hope to be victorious, to win, at that time a small lady, a girl, put some hope, add some hope, and she boosts the confidence of the soldiers of French army. Same character was there. If you can compare the lady with that Bahubali, the same situation was there. Okay, now moving towards our play. So before starting the play, I tell you the background. The play begins at the time when all the northern France and some part of the west, southwest, were under the foreign control. Not foreign control means here England, and Bulgarians control the others. Next, Bulgarians also control some French part. The city of Orleans, it is a French city. Orleans, one of the few remaining French cities, was held by English. Orleans was just away from the English and Bulgarians. Orleans city, it was not captured by Bulgarians and English. It was not captured yet. The year is 1429. Captain Robert D. Baudricourt, it's the name of that captain, Captain Robert Baudricourt. A military officer is seated at the table. His steward stand facing steward, assistant steward, and Captain Robert were discussing about the next plan. They were sitting that military camp on the table, and they were discussing what to do, what should they can do, what should they can do for their country, the nation. This was the situation. Robert, the first character, Robert, I told you to throw the girl out. You have 50 armed soldiers and dozens of strong servants to carry out my orders. Are they afraid of her? Means here, Robert telling to steward that whichever the girl standing beside our room, throw her away. We don't have any need of that girl. We have a strong army, we have strong soldiers. So tell that girl to go back. Steward, no sir. His assistant is answering him, no sir, we are afraid of you. She puts the courage in us. She really doesn't seem to be afraid of anything. Perhaps you could frighten her. Steward is answering to Robert that, no sir, you are wrong. You are afraid of that girl. Because that girl put courage in us. It means our soldier lost the hope, and she, again, she starts, she shows the hope to us. You are afraid of that girl. Robert grieved, very seriously. Robert, seriously. Perhaps, where is she now? Where is she now? That girl you are talking about, where is she now? Steward, down in the countryside, sir. Down in the countryside, she is nearby us. Robert goes to the window and asks the soldier to send the girls up. Robert's order to the soldier that they have to send that girl up to meet to the Robert. The girl enters. She is well built, strong and trim girl of 17 to 80 years. Just 17 to 80 years. Strong country girl of 17 to 18 years. The squeal, glum, neither frighten of nor stop her. She speaks confidently. The confidence just showing in her eyes. She was very confident there when she met first time to Robert. Joan, now the main character of the story, main character of the play. Joan, good morning, dear Squeal. Squeal is her officer. Good morning, Captain Squeal. You are to give me a horse and armor and some soldiers and send me to the dolphin. She directly demanded to the higher officer of the army, that is Robert, "Sir, give me some soldiers, horse, armor, and send me to the dolphin. You have to make the preparation to send me to the dolphin." Joe telling to Robert. "Robert, the girl is mad. Why didn't you tell me so, you blockhead?" It means Robert is telling the steward, "Is that girl mad?" Here the higher officer, who is brave and courageous officer, put their arm. They didn't have any hope to fight with that English army. And she is the girl of just 17 to 18 years and she is ready to fight with that army. Is she gone mad? You are blockhead, steward? Are you joking? Where the French is not in the state to fight with the Englishmen, because near about 70 to 80% part of France is captured by Englishmen, and here is the situation, and in that such very serious condition, a girl of 17-18 years, she told me, she demanded me that she needed a horse and armor and some soldiers, and she is going to free that French. Is she mad? Are you blockhead? You are presenting that girl to me. You are directly admitting to that girl to me. This was the situation. Steward, sir, do not anger. Give her what she wants. Robert, steward was too much confident about Joan. And that's why steward told to Robert, "Sir, do not anger. Just do what she telling to us. Just do. Just provide her what she demanded." "Robert, I shall send you back to your father with the orders you put under the lock and key." Robert is too much intensified, too much angry. And Robert told to that girl, "You listen me, you girl. If you don't listen me, I will send back to your father and lock you. And lock you, it means I will never allow you to go to the battlefield." That was the situation. "Just go back to your home." This was going on. "Just go back to your home. Joan, you think you will square? But it won't happen that way. You said you would not see me, but here I am." It means before this meeting, many times she wanted to meet to Robert, but Robert rejected it, denied it. That's why she again remembered to Robert that most of the time, "Sir, you told me that you don't want to meet me, you didn't want to meet me, but till I'm here, you can talk. So what do you think? So what do you think? I am too much confident about my target, and whatever I decided, that I do." She told to Robert, "I'm too much confident about my target, of my decision. जो मैंने ठान लिया वो मैं करके रहती हूँ. इसके पहले भी आपने बोला था कि मुझे दिखना मत, फिर भी मैं आपके सामने खड़ी हूँ. That was the situation. So you are assuming, Robert said, so you are assuming that you will give you what you want. I will give you what you want. It means Robert is telling to John that it means you have decided that what you demanded to me, that will be provided by me. You have directly decided that. You think I will do my part. The same thing, this was the situation before the battle, before the war. So dear student, here we stop for the first part. We will see the next story in the play, or next what happened in the play in the next part. Thank you very much.